श्रुतिर्माता पृष्ठा दिशति भगवत आराधना विधि यथा मातुत्वाणि स्थितिरपि तथा वक्ति भगिनी पुराणाद्यादिवा सहज निवहास्ति तदमुगा अतः सत्यं ज्ञातं मुरहर भवानेव शरणम्। सो दिस लर्नेड सेज बाय हिज एक्सपीरियंस ही इज सेइंग दैट after studying all Vedic literature and all Upanishads, Vedanta, Puranam, four Vedas, Ramayana, Mahabharata, volumes of literature. So, the conclusion is that, oh my dear Lord, Bhavan eva saranam, you are the only ultimate shelter. This is the last stage of knowledge, as it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Bahunam janmanam. After struggling for many, many births to acquire knowledge. So, when one comes to this point, bhavaneva saranam, you are the ultimate center. That is the perfection of knowledge. Our editor has written very nice article, Krishna is the end of knowledge. Yes. When you come to Krishna point, then everything is knowledge, knowable, of course. So far our knowledge is concerned, but so far Krishna is concerned, he is unlimited. Nobody can know him. But at least to that point, if we can reach, that is also very difficult. Simply to reach that to that point, they struggling. So many scholars, so many, still coming to the nearest point, still he says, oh, not Krishna, not Krishna. It is impersonal, it is impersonal. So this knowledge is acquired by the grace of the Supreme Lord, by the association of pure devotees, satang prasangat mama vija sangila. One can attain this qualification, and if somewhere other, either by faith or by knowledge or by association or by accidents, if one comes to this point that Krishna, the Supreme, is the ultimate goal, then his life is perfect. Adyayana tatta Krishna swayam bhagavan sarur shakti rupetar ayavastha. Now, Lord Chaitanya says, the Krishna, the absolute truth, Advaita Tattva, is absolute truth, Krishna. Swayam Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality, the absolute truth in the ultimate, he is a person. In the Bhagavad Gita, you will see in the 11th chapter that Krishna was requested by Arjuna to show his universal power. Because for ordinary persons, that universal form is gigantic universal form is supposed to be, that is God. But they do not know param bhava vajananta. They do not know that this universal form is only an offshoot of Krishna. They do not know. Less intelligent class of men, they think impersonal form or the universal form or even the 400 Vishnu form, they consider that they are greater. But in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, you will find that Krishna, by the request of Arjuna, assumed his universal form, Vishwarupa. Now, after seeing the Vishwarupa, Arjuna was afraid. He was in friendly relationship with Krishna, and when he saw his Vishwarupa, he became too much perturbed in his mind. Oh, what mistake I have done. I took Krishna as my friend. and I do not know how much offences I have committed. Friendly relation, there are sometimes very slackened languages and used, sometimes calling, you Krishna, sometimes so many things, friendly relations, they are very relaxation relation. So he thought that I have committed so much offences to Krishna, and he begged pardon out of my impudence, out of my ignorance. I have done so many things, please excuse. Just like a father excuses his son, just like a friend excuses his friend, just like husband excuses wife, or the wife excuses, these things are there. Then again, he asked Krishna to assume his 400 Narayan rupees. Krishna also showed him the Narayan 400 rupees. And then again Krishna transformed himself again into the 200 Shamasandha with flute as it is, he transformed himself. Now the question is, if Krishna is ordinary person, just like some foolish commentators say, not to Krishna, then how could he assume this Vishwarupa and the Narayan Rupa? Can an ordinary person assume that rupa, that form? It is not possible. Therefore, the answer in the Bhagavad Gita is abhajananti mang mudha. Now there is stated param bhava abhajananta. They do not know. Now Arjuna wanted to confirm this param bhava, that the less intelligent class of men who are fond of the universal form, or the Vishnu, Narayan form, and there are so many innumerable forms. Advaita, Achyuti, Anadi, Anantarupa. Krishna has Anantarupa. But the ultimate supreme form is Krishna. They do not know. Param Bhavam Ajananta. Ajananta means they do not know the Param Bhavam. So here the same thing is confirmed by Lord Chaitanya, that he says, Adyayan Tattva Krishna Swayam Bhagavan. So the absolute truth, the ultimate stage of realizing absolute truth is to understand Krishna. Brahma realization, Paramatma realization, they are not perfect realization of the absolute truth, partial realization. Brahma realization means realization of the absolute truth in eternity. That's all. Paramatma realization of the absolute truth is a realization of eternity and knowledge. And Krishna realization means full realization of the absolute truth, means eternity, knowledge and bliss. Without Krishna knowledge, we cannot be blissful. But by nature, we are blissful. It is Brahma Sutra, in the Vedanta Sutra, it is stated, Anandamaya Abhyasat, every living entity, Brahma, living entities, they are Brahma. And Krishna is also Parabrahma. So Brahma and Parabrahma, both of them are, by nature, joyful. They want joy, enjoyment. So our joyfulness is in connection with Krishna. Just like fire and the sparks of fire. The sparks of fire so long manifested with the fire, it is beautiful. And as soon as the sparks of fire falls down from the original fire, it is extinguished. No more beautiful. So we are in the same relationship with Krishna. He is the complete whole. We are parts and parcels. Just like the complete whole fire and the sparks of fire. When the fire and the sparks are displayed, it looks very nice. both of them enjoy. And when the spark, of course, fire has unlimited potency to produce sparks. But the sparks, when he is out of the fireplace, then it loses its identity. And this is called conditioned life. We are in that conditioned life. We are fire, sparks of fire. But because we are in material contamination, therefore we have become conditioned. So knowledge means to understand, beginning of knowledge is to understand one's constitutional position. That knowledge is imparted in the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, that you are not this body. You are spirit, spark. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi kaumara jauvanam jada tata dehantaram prapti dhiras tattanamayati. So you are spark, spiritual spark. You are simply changing dress. That is your condition. So, Lord Chaitanya says, Attayana Tatta Krishna Sang Bhagavan, Sang Bhagavan, the absolute truth. Sarup Shakti Rupetar Hayavasta. He is situated in his internal potency. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, Jada Jada Hidhanmasa Glani Bhavati Bharata, Abhutyanam Adhanmasa. Paritranaya sadhanam vinashaya sa dhiskita sambhavami atmaya atmaya internal potency. He is situated in the spiritual world by internal potency. And this material world is external potency. Therefore, although external potency is also Krishna's potency, it is not different from Krishna, but Krishna is not here in the external potency. Krishna is in the internal potency. Although this potency is not different, therefore it is inferior. It is inferior energy, it is God. And this is explained very nicely in the Bhagavad Gita.